Hello everyone and welcome back. I'm Diane Désir, and since I did a few videos on the dolman sleeve, I decided to show you two little things that you could do to your dolman block to make it a little more special. The first one, I did it on the front, it's the boat neck. And the second one is in the back. I am going to show you how to do a nice drape neck that you could use the technique for the front or the back. I'm using today the dolman block that I did with you in one of my previous video. Today I use the middle angle, just so you know that you could use any of them. So I will be starting with the front pattern. So I'm going to take my block that have the seam allowance already and just retrace it on another piece of paper. Now the main idea when you want to do a boat neck is to enlarge your neck, especially at the shoulder, so your neckline becomes as straight as possible. On my dolman block, I did keep a reference for the tip of the shoulder, so it's going to be very helpful because you cannot go over that point. The top is just going to fall, and even you should go maybe 2 or 3 centimeters inside that point. The next thing we could do is cheat a little bit. I would say if you do it your top in knit like me today, you could go up at the center front from the original neckline about a centimeter and a half. That's what I did. But if you're doing a woven top from the basic neckline, don't go up more than 0.5 or 5 millimeters. Then you're going to do a 90 degree line from that point for about 2 centimeters. Then we're going to trace a curved line from that line to the shoulder point that we found with a very, very light curve, as soft as you can. Now about the finishing of that part, if you're doing woven fabric, you could trace a separate facing, for sure parallel to your new neckline. But if you're doing your boat neck in knit, just like I did, you might want to do a self-fold facing. For the self-fold facing, you could still use your 5 centimeters that you used to, but this time trace it parallel towards the top. Now you see that I continue the line for a little while, and the reason is that we need that length to hold the facing down. So now what you have to do is just fold on a little part of the neck, the part that is closer to the shoulder, just like that, and then you're going to retrace the top part of the shoulder to get your jug. Like I told you at the presentation, they are very simple and easy modification to do to your basic dolman pattern. The front is finished. Now we're going to do the back pattern, and you'll see that it's as easy as the first one that I just showed you. But when you retrace your back, just leave some space at the center back. When your back is traced, since I'm doing a top and I want it to match with the front I just did, I'm going to report the final neck and shoulder point. So it's important that you go inside because we have seam allowance, the intersection of the new neckline and the shoulder line. So right here, I'm going to report that point to get it on my back. So I'm overlapping my piece and just retrace. Once you have your neck and shoulder point reported from the front to the back, you're going to need to take one measurement or on yourself or on your mannequin from about this distance at the shoulder. I want you to decide the depth that you want your neck. For this example, I just decide a point that I want it to be dropped until there. Then the next thing to do is to measure from the depth to the shoulder. Now you see that I'm using a square to take my measurement because I'm going to need the square to do my next move. And the next move is to hold your square at the neck and shoulder point, the new one, and pivot your square until the bottom of your square touch the waist and center back point. When it's in position, you could just trace both sides of the square. Now for sure, you don't know it yet, but your pattern is finished. The only thing that you're missing is your self-fold facing at the new neck, so right here. And what happened is that We move the center back to add some more fabric. So of course, if my center back was unfold, my new center back is also unfold. Here again, I'm going to trace my self-fold facing with a 5 centimeter wide measurement. I also elongate my new center back, and I'm going to fold again on my neckline to be able to retrace the top part of my shoulder. Now that the jug is done for the neckline, we have one more little correction to do since we lost the 90 degree at the waist and center back. So what we have to do to correct it, we just need to elongate the new center back. I'm not giving you distance or measurement right now because it all depends on the angle that you pivot. But you have to do a correction and you try to do it not on a too long distance. Over here, I'm in half scale and this is about 3 centimeter long, so maybe 5 or 6 in full measure. And then from that point, you're going to square a line that should be again up 3 to 5 centimeter, and you're going to square for a little while. Then we're going to connect this 90 degree to the waist level. Now we're ready to cut the pattern. So we have the 2 pattern piece to do that green top that you saw on my mannequin. This is exactly what I did. And the last thing you might want to do before cutting it is to check to see if the angle of the jug are both the same measurement. So put them together at the shoulder point, hold it at the shoulder and neck point, and pivot one on top of the other. And you might cut the excess, if you do have a little excess, just soften the line and remove what you have extra on one of the pieces. Now to assemble this top, I don't think it could be more simple. You just sew your side seam from the waist to the wrist, and then you sew your shoulder from the wrist all the way to the neck and shoulder point. You have a big angle there, so you should easily be able to see it. Then you pivot your fabric so both jug are even, and you sew all the way up. When it's done, you're going to fold the facing part or towards the front or towards the back, just like that. And stitch again, so it's going to hold to your shoulder. Now I wanted to show you in real fabric what it looks like. So here you have my front neckline, the straight one. And on the side, I'm going to show you the seam that I told you to do. This is the shoulder and the jug I was talking about. So after this seam is done, and you do the second seam that I show you, I'm just going to pin it for now so you could see. When you fold them back in the right position, so front towards the front and back towards the back, you get that nice corner finishing. That's it for today. I hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching, and I see you next time.